We are going to move on now because we've got the next fight coming up. And we've actually got Sam Nowhere to Hyde. He fights dangerous David Vicenza. Like we said, Bobby, you know, it'd be nice to see, well, for me in particular, because I've not actually seen Sam fight yet, but I've heard some good things. I've heard he's a banger. I've heard he can move about a bit.
Yeah, so you know, he's got, like we said before, he's got a good pedigree, a good amateur record, and he's got a good team behind him. You know, his dad's very involved in him, and he's got Ensley Bingham there training him, and with Carl Thompson at the Champs camp, and you know that place is absolutely steeped in history. You know, every fighter that walked out of them doors was a champion, a British champion, a European champion, a world champion. So you know, he's got everything going for him, this kid. You know, and you know, his opponent's coming over here, and another Eastern European.
Yeah,
and you don't know.
Well, you never know, like you say, you never know what you get.
Yeah, you don't know what you get with these Eastern Europeans, you know what I mean? So we're looking for Sam maybe to get the first stoppage of the night on last promotion show here from Bede, Fright Night.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Halloween.
Is it his opponent?
Max is looking good with his mask on here.
I knew that was coming. But like we say, we're going to go over to our MC now anyway, Craig Stephen, to introduce the fighters.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we got on with the action here at the Castle Leisure Centre, Bury. Would you please welcome now, all the way from the Czech Republic, Dangerous David Vicena.
Dangerous Dave. Dangerous Dave's on his way. We have now Dangerous Dave walking towards the ring. Dangerous Dave on Fright Night. Sounds like a monster movie, doesn't it, Bart?
What was your nickname, Bobby, as a boxer?
The KO Kid.
Was it?
I don't even need to have to tell you why they call me that, do, because that speaks for itself, doesn't it? Manchester's own KO Kid.
You had to retire, didn't you, for sore hands, wasn't it?
Oh, cauliflower hearts.
Ref kept standing on him.
My first 25 fights was all on knockouts, and then I won one.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming to the ring from
tell you what, he does it proper, Pat, doesn't he? You know what I mean?
I think it's great.
You know, all the lights, all the smoke and everything, it's great, isn't it? He just needs more support, doesn't he, with what he's doing, because, you know, it's up to the paying public. It's all about, you know, getting people to come out and support your local promoter, and, you know, that's what they need. Pat, you know, I know it's a bit of a tough night because it's Halloween and a lot of people are out with the kids and that, but, you know, Pat's putting his money where his mouth is with these shows, you know, and we can all see here tonight that he's probably going to be in the red at the end of it, the show, you know what I mean? But, you know, it'd be nice if you can get more people out, come and support your Manchester promoters.
Leisure Centre in Bury, where Black Flash Promotions is very proud to bring you 4 3-minute rounds and international cruiserweight contest. Our timekeeper at the bell from Sheffield, Mr. Barry Binder. Referee in charge from Doncaster, star referee, Mr. Michael Alexander. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing in the blue corner, wearing the black shorts with grey trim, on the scales of 14 stone 3 pounds, he comes to the ring in his 35th professional contest, from Brno in the Czech Republic, Dangerous David Vicena. And across the ring in the red corner, wearing the white shorts with blue and silver trim on the scales at 14 stone 8 pounds from 5 contests. He has 4 wins, 1 win coming by way of knockout, only 1 defeat from Sale, Greater Manchester.
Right, lads, you both know the rules, so let's just have a good clean fight, okay? Most of all, remember to defend yourselves at all times. Just go. Keep it.
Check is out. Round one.
Okay, this is a 4-3 cruiserweight contest. Sam Nowhere to Hyde in the white shorts fighting out the red corner.
Oh, great right hand.
Takes the right hand straight away and again the left. And the guy he's fighting here is a well-skilled opponent. He's, you know, he's boxed.
Oh, that's a lovely jab by Sam Hyde. He's just straight away started off, straight away banging, hitting this kid at will, hasn't he? There's the first. Another right hand. He's hitting with 3 right hands unanswered here, hasn't he, Barks?
He has, and this guy's been in with Robert Alanius, this guy. He's not, you know.
No mug, is he? He knows his way around a boxing ring, doesn't he? You know, but like you say, these Eastern European backs are always normally pretty durable and pretty tough, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah.
And he's been hit with he's been hit with some lovely clean right hands, hasn't he? But I think that's the answer there, that body shot. There you go.
And again.
This is it, Bart.
Well, like
it's over.
Referee start the fight. It looks a little bit premature for me, to be honest.
I don't know what his trainer thinks about it. He's videoing it there. Look, Bart. Well, his trainer's videoing it there, Bart.
Yeah.
Not even got in to see if his man's all right.
That was a strange stoppage, that, wasn't it, Bob Riller, to be fair. So
it was only going one way, wasn't it, Bart?
It was only going one way, and it was from the body shot. First stoppage of the night, then.
Yeah. It was only going one way. When he hit him with that body shot, Bart, he backed up, and he didn't want no more, did he? You could see that, couldn't you?
To be fair, I mean, with the first shot he hit him, it looked like, I don't really want to be in it.
No,
so it was, you know... So it's definitely,
and he didn't complain, did he, Barks?
No, but like you say, you know, he has been in with, he's been in with some, you know, title challenges. This
guy. Hang on a minute, his trainer's getting on the ring now. See if his man's all right after he's done his videoing.
That was a strange one, yeah. Just going, alluding to what Bobby's talking about. The trainer was actually videoing the fight then, as it was happening. So, but it was, like I say, strange stoppage, but. You know, like as we said earlier on, there's nothing Sam Hyde can do. He's here for the W, and that's what he got.
Listen, Sam's walked out, hit the kid, hurt him, and just put it on him straight away. So, that's what he's done.
Yeah.
And that's what he should have done, and that's what he did.
Okay, we're going over to the MC, Craig Stevens.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as always here this evening, before we declare the result, please your appreciation for both our boxers in the ring. The end comes at 1 minute and 11 seconds of round number one, where referee Michael Alexander stops the contest. In his opinion, David Vicena in no position to continue. The winner from Sale, Sam Nowhere2 Hyde. And please, ladies and gentlemen, for our visitor from the Czech Republic, David Vicena.
Okay, unfortunately we didn't get to see too much of Dangerous David.
Wasn't that dangerous, I don't think.
But a good performance, as we say, from Sam Hyde, so it'd be interesting to hear what he's got to say about it, really.
Listen, you can only beat the kid they put in front of you, can't they?
It'd be nice to kind of see it go a little bit longer though, just to see if I don't think, you know, the result would have changed, but
no.
You know, it might.
But there again, Barks, the ref's in there to do a job, isn't it? I know it's Halloween, mate, but you don't have to be that bloodthirsty, do you?
No, now, but you know what I mean? It just felt a little bit premature. But anyway, we'll listen to what Sam Hyde has to say now.
So, Sam, I know you don't get paid overtime in this game, but 1 minute 11 seconds, your mate's asking you to go out trick-or-treat. What was that all about?
Since my draw, I've just wanted a big KO, but to get back up to where I should be. Some, you know, a talented young boxer, and I've just been, you know, boxing rubbish. And this fight meant a lot. I did want the KO, but I won't go for it. And that shows. Everything ends has been telling me. It's proof in the pudding. I did it in a minute. He said, "Don't go for the knockout, and you'll knock everyone out because you got power." I did it in a minute. So proof in the pudding.
And then he certainly made a few people happy in here tonight. Looks like you sold a few tickets, mate.
I'd just like to thank everyone, all my sponsors, everyone who came, because it was fun. That support was amazing. I appreciate it.
And Ensley, you've been mentioned there, so you're obviously working on a lot of things with Sam outside. Was you happy with that performance? I suppose it's difficult not to be, is it?
I would have preferred Sam to get the four rounds, to be honest. But
you want
to
put him back in there?
We'll do some pads in the back.
Well done, both, and all the best. Look forward to following you again, Sam.
Thank you.
Okay, as we said, Bobby, he was in there nice, short and sweet. Done, dusted.
What?
I'm saying it was nice, short and sweet. Done, dusted.
Mate, listen, he's got in with his kid, and like you say, he's hit him with the first one, and the kid's half wilted a little bit, so he's just put it on him. That's exactly what he should be doing.
Yeah.
And exactly the way he fought that fight, them Sam Hyde, that's how it should be. You know, and he's done it in front of a nice little home crowd here, sold a load of tickets, so he's had a great night, hasn't he?
Yeah, everybody's happy.
Everybody's happy.
We have got a short break now coming up, but do stick around because we have got two fantastic fights coming up. We've got Michael Gomez Jr. and we've got top of the bill, Zelfa Barrett. So make sure you stick around. Like I say, if you want to get in contact or involved with the show, on the hashtag, it's BBTV Live.
You're not going to start bidding on all this stuff now, are you, Bob?
No, not for me, mate. Can't afford it, Bob.
Normally can't keep your hand down, no. You better sit on your hands, aren't you?